Hey guys, I hope you're doing well. Today we're going to be doing something a little bit different. Over the years, a lot of you guys have been asking me a bunch of questions that kind of relate all back to the same idea, and that is networking and how to build connections in the music industry. Now, me, you know, a person who started 5 years ago with zero connections in the music industry, I didn't even know what networking was, you know, a YouTube bedroom guitarist. It's tough. It's a long road, especially if you're trying to find ways to actually build relationships with people and reach out to all these people that you would love to work with. So I just want to give some helpful tips that I wish I even gave myself when I started out when it came to networking that I think might really help a lot of you guys at least get started in the industry, starting to talk to people and build those really, really important connections. So I'm going to try to organize all these ideas and tips into three different important segments. The first one being the mindset you really have to be in for networking. The second one being actually networking, reaching out to these people, trying to build connections. And then the third one being maintaining these connections. So before you even start to make connections, it's really important to get in the proper mindset of wanting to really build these long-lasting relationships with people. And the first thing I always think it's so important to focus on is to be respectful to everyone you meet in this industry. Word travels fast. If you're an asshole, other people will know it. No one's gonna wanna work with you. Just be nice with everyone you fucking meet. You know, you don't have to kiss their ass, you know, if you actually don't like the person, but don't disrespect them unless they've disrespected you. And even if that's the case, sometimes it's better just to, you know, shrug it off. If someone's being an asshole, whatever. You know, let them be an asshole. That's gonna be their limiting factor in life. No one's gonna wanna work with them anyways. So why do you have to be the person, you know, to kinda further that, you know, to start drama? Just be a nice person with everyone you meet. And honestly, that itself will take you so much further than even being the best musician ever or anything like that. Just be respectful. Second thing when it comes to mindset is to treat people like they're people. Okay, it's so important. I've seen it a million times when either smaller bands or fans of bigger bands treat those bigger guys just like they're a number. You know, they treat journalists just as a means to an end, you know? Hey, journalist, dude, I've never talked to you. I'm not even gonna say hi. Check out my band. You know, it makes those people feel like shit. You know, it's an inhuman interaction. It's just you're using them to kind of further your own agenda to hopefully get people to check out your band. And I'm not saying there's anything wrong with saying, hey, check out my band, but you gotta do it in a kind of human interactive way. You know, not just throw your fucking link and check out my band and that's it. You know, hit up the person. Hey person, I've followed your shit for a long time. You know, I like this, I like this. Maybe I saw your live show and I thought your shit's really cool. And, you know, my own band is kind of along the similar lines of a genre or whatever. And I thought you might like it. Simple as that. You know, whenever I get emails like that, I always check out the bands, even if I don't really have time. Because they hit me up, they took the time, and they're trying to actually be respectful in that manner and treat me like I'm a person. I'm not just a fucking number. And it's so important to really treat these people like they're people. Because they can tell right away, you know, if you hit up a journalist and you just say, here's my shit, they're not going to share your shit. You hit up a band, they're not going to check out your shit if you just say, here's my, you know, band song. So just treat people like they're actually people. And that itself will already start to build relationships with people and go a long way. Number three, when it comes to mindset, is to understand your perceived value and what you have to offer within the music industry. What makes you unique? What makes you stick out of the crowd of, you know, the million other people doing the exact same shit as you? Right? Do you have really cool music videos? Do you have really insane live shows? Or are you just a really cool fucking person to hang around with and chill that people love to talk to and take out on the road, right? These are all things that bigger bands are thinking about when they want to take out these smaller bands. Because it's not always about having the exact same fan base or having, you know, a million fucking followers. A lot of the time, bigger bands will take out smaller bands just because they want to hang out with them or because they really love their music and believe in them. Right? Because they stick out. Those smaller bands are sticking out somehow from the crowd. So as you kind of get more in that mindset and you start to think in the mindset of, okay, I want to work with these people, but what do I really have to offer them? Why would they want to work with me? You're going to start to understand your perceived value a little more, you know, what people think your value is. And as you start to understand that more, get a better sense of it, you're going to be more confident in what your value is. Sometimes you're going to overestimate it, you know, go maybe too big, and that's okay. And sometimes you're going to underestimate it and maybe even get, you know, kind of the short end of the stick in that sense. But you're going to get a better sense over time with experience. And when you get that right on, you're going to start to be able to know as soon as you hit up maybe a bigger artist, before they even hit you back, if they'll likely say no or yes to what you're asking for them in terms of working with them. All right, now to actually find the connections. What do you do? Where do you go? Well, first thing that I recommend is honestly start by utilizing all social media. You know, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, whatever it is, put your content on there and actually become part of the communities on there, right? If you're posting something on Facebook, join, I don't know, a bunch of deathcore, you know, Facebook groups, if that's the genre of your band, or rock Facebook groups. And you're gonna see people posting, you know, reply, become part of those communities genuinely. And you're gonna start so many just natural, genuine relationships with people who are kind of doing the same thing you are. And it's just a really good step in the right direction. So now that you've hopefully been getting involved within those communities in a very organic and not forceful way, people are gonna start to notice you a little more. You know, when you post something, they're gonna know who you are, and vice versa, you're gonna start to know other people. You're gonna naturally start talking with each other and naturally build these very fundamental, you know, smaller scale relationships, you know, and then somebody's gonna say, hey, you know, let's work together, let's do something together. And this is what comes to my second point, and it's very important, and that is to say yes to almost every little opportunity that slightly furthers your career to that goal. You know, as long as you really like the idea of the collaboration, it's something fun, don't worry too much about, you know, oh, will this get a fucking tons of views or whatever. Do it for fun, and it's going to take time, a lot of effort, and you definitely probably won't make any money from it, you know, when you're just starting. But just do it, you know, because you really want to do it. And the more you do those, the more other people will want to work with you, because they'll be like, oh, he collabed with him, that's cool, I want to work with him too, etc., etc., etc. And that's going to keep going and scaling and scaling, and eventually maybe one of those people you work with is going to know someone bigger on the scene, and he's going to be like, oh, those guys worked together, it was really cool. You know, then they might actually want to hit you up to work together, or you might be able to hit them up to work together and do something fun, and just kind of keeps building like that. So really focus on the community and kind of be a yes man is kind of my point. But even more importantly, while you know you're on the socials trying to build your networks and, you know, talking to musicians and all that, it's very important that you do so on a secure network like the VPN provided by Surfshark. The Surfshark VPN secures your sensitive data. If you're ever using any sort of public Wi-Fi, it's very easy for someone to hack into your computer and steal your private and personal information. Surfshark's VPN makes it so that regardless of where you are, your data is fully encrypted through their VPN, making it so no one else can access your information. Now, for those of you who love to binge watch series on your favorite streaming services, Surfshark provides access to geo-restricted content, allowing you to watch completely new content from the same streaming services you already use. This also helps you avoid geographic price discrimination when searching for the best deals on air ticket, hotel, or even car rental services. Most importantly, Surfshark VPN allows you to avoid internet censorship. So no matter which country you're in, you can use any sites you want without anyone being able to track you. Get Surfshark VPN right now at surfshark.deals/nick and use the code NICK to instantly get 83% off and 1 month free. My next tip when it comes to finding connections is to not just network with people for the sake of using them to network. You know what I mean? Actually try to build connections with these people and kind of relationships and actually talk to them. You know, they're people too. You know, they're not just a means to an end. So it's really important to treat them like you respect them, like they're actually people. And, you know, you don't just hit them up every time you only need them and that's it. Now I'm going to close this all with something really important, and that is to maintain these relationships, maintain these connections that you've made, right? Because, yeah, it's cool. Maybe, you know, you've worked with someone you really wanted to work with, you collaborated. And then what happens after that, though? You know, a lot of these relationships just kind of end. It's done. You don't really talk to that person ever again. They're doing their own thing. But, you know, if you really connect with that person, you connect with their band, you connect with their music, maintain that. You know, if they're posting shit on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, leave a like, leave a fun little comment. Actually, you know, have fun with that stuff. Hit them up once in a while and be like, hey, man, fuck, it's been a while. How you doing? You know what I mean? As long as it's authentic and not forced, that's really what matters. So just keep that going and just be nice and respectful and fucking be open to, you know, doing things and working with people. And it's gonna just kind of work out where you eventually keep naturally climbing up the ladder, as you would say, meeting kind of more people, meeting bigger musicians and all that, because you're just going to start to be known as just kind of a nice, cool person that people just want to work with and all that. So try to build that reputation for yourself. And it takes time. It's a grind, but you know, it's worth it if that's really what you want to go and do. All right, so be a part of that community and give it your all. But yeah, guys, I hope you liked this video. You know, if you did, if this was helpful, be sure to hit that subscribe button down below. Leave a like, comment, you know, what you thought, you know, if you want me to do more of these types of videos or your experiences, you know, your own experiences with networking. I'd love to hear some of those. But yeah, and much love to Surfshark again for sponsoring this video. Go check them out. I actually have been using them quite a bit for VPN change for Netflix, and it's cool to watch shows that aren't just Canadian Netflix. But yeah, it's a really cool company. Go show them love. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.